You're watching Unrelent Gaming. This is Beerus, the God of Destruction. Make sure you subscribe to Unrelent Gaming and push the like button for me, or else I'll hakai you from existence.
Oh, and do make sure to watch the entire video all the way through. And follow Unrelent Gaming on both Instagram and Twitter.
Whis, enough. On to the video.
So Dragon Ball Super manga chapter number 71 had just now blown the doors open to the upcoming battle involving Granola, Vegeta, and Goku, and considering how the heaters are now beginning to orchestrate this entire facade behind the scenes, and being the puppet masters and pulling the strings while Goku, Vegeta, and Granola are completely oblivious to the fact that they're being lied to and now further positioned in having to take each other out, the question going forward is what exactly do the heaters, specifically Elec, have in mind by having to rid Vegeta, Goku, and Granola from the picture, as of course he is looking to take over Frieza's army and later having to get rid of him, but more importantly is how exactly is Elec going to do this and what exactly is going to be the fate of Granola, Goku, and Vegeta once they do in fact end up meeting and fighting each other in the upcoming Dragon Ball Super manga chapter. As a quick reminder, in case you are new to the channel and just so happen to have a love and passion for all things Dragon Ball and anime, then I do encourage you guys to go on ahead and smash that subscribe button, as well as also turning on all notifications to never miss a single video posted onto this channel, on top of also giving this video a big fat thumbs up by slapping that like button down below if you guys are hyped and excited to finally see Granola battle against Goku and Vegeta, which I do think is going to be a bit more complex than meets the eye, only because this fight with Goku, Vegeta, and Granola could literally go either way. Now the thing is, this fight involving Granola, Goku, and Vegeta could literally go in any direction. Now first things first, you don't want to have the opposition who stands against Goku and Vegeta look weak from the beginning, only because you want to further develop said character in establishing themselves as being a legitimate and credible threat to said opposition, which just so happens to be right now Goku and Vegeta. But at the same time, you don't want to diminish Goku and Vegeta's characters either, especially after right now, after having to see both Goku and Vegeta undergo and complete their training with the gods, and Goku having to follow the path of Whis and Vegeta having to follow the path of Beerus. It's well established right now that Goku and Vegeta right now are unquestionably the strongest they've ever been. So what do we do moving forward, especially with Granola? Now, I'm gonna go on record and say that there's no way that even if Granola is the strongest in Universe 7, will he be able to trump that of Mastered Ultra Instinct Goku. Instead, I think MUI Goku, if Goku were to use the silver-haired form, would annihilate Granola unless Granola is hiding more power than what he's letting on. At this point, the evidence substantiates the fact that Goku, while using the silver-haired form, Mastered Ultra Instinct, would be looked at as being significantly stronger than what Granola could possibly be. And in terms of Vegeta, the whole premise of Vegeta having to learn Hakai is to be able to erase anything, objects, and individuals literally from existence without a trace. So I think that if Vegeta were to concentrate enough in putting his power, energy, and mind into specifically focusing on using this technique on a single individual, in this case being Granola, then I believe that there's no doubt that yes, Vegeta could potentially, without much effort, be able to Hakai Granola. But what about Granola? Well, this goes back to my previous point in the idea that I think that early on from this battle involving the three, despite the circumstances of either introducing Granola versus Vegeta first, or Granola versus Goku first, either way from the beginning, I have no doubt that they're going to purposely allow Granola to best Goku and Vegeta until either the concept of Hakai is introduced by Vegeta or the concept of Mastered Ultra Instinct is then introduced by Goku. Because I find it kind of weird that Whis is trying to insinuate by telling Goku that the angels are always using Ultra Instinct, which has been established many, many arcs ago, but he wants Goku to kind of use and reform his body in always having to wield Ultra Instinct without transforming into the silver-haired state. So what better way than to make Granola look good than to body a base form UI Goku as the fight progresses? So that is the only reason I think why they introduced the concept of allowing Goku to use UI in base, only because You have to have the enemy, the opposition, look good, which bodying Super Saiyan God, bodying Super Saiyan Blue isn't really anything new, but it is redundant because we've seen that many of times over. But what better way than to have everyone kind of kick things off by using their base forms, a little bit of Hakai here, a little bit of Ultra Instinct and base there, and you kind of already go from there in establishing the premise that, whoa, Granola is in fact worthy of us having to use the maximum potential and power that we have, and if we get bested as we are now, as we've seen them train on Beerus's planet, then what better way for them to kick it up a notch or two than by using their full power, as we've seen demonstrated during the Moral arc, and even during the demonstration of them having to train with both Beerus and Whis, than to go all out against Granola and then having to force Granola in doing the same thing, unleashing his full power. But by the end of it, I don't see Granola winning. By the end of it, I don't see Goku winning, nor do I see Vegeta winning. Is it possible for someone like Mastered Ultra Instinct Goku to win? In my opinion, yes. Is it possible for Vegeta to be able to get close enough with enough focus and Hakai and Granola from existence? Absolutely. Is it also possible to suggest the overall idea that Granola can win? Absolutely. But by the end of all of this, I don't see that being the case, because we have another third party that's pulling the strings from the shadows, of course that being none other than the Heaters. And to be perfectly honest with you, I don't know about you guys, but I am getting serious Batman versus Superman vibes. Now, why am I saying this? Well, for those that have seen Batman versus Superman in 2016, we know that Batman wanted to fight Superman because he saw him as the opposition. Superman was in fact not the enemy, but as soon as they fought, we saw a common trait. Of course, Martha, the name of Bruce Wayne's parents, and of course the mother of Clark Kent, was brought up in bringing them together. After then having to gain more of an understanding as to where the other person was coming from, they then later teamed up with Wonder Woman to fight Doomsday. And in this case, Doomsday can be looked at as the Heaters, while Batman, Superman, and Wonder Woman are of course Goku, Vegeta, and Granola. Because make no mistake about it, at some point during this fight, someone is going to let something slip up, meaning in a sense where Granola is going to possibly call out the Saiyans as being Frieza's assassins, whereas the Saiyans are going to call out Granola in wanting to exterminate a said species that was ironically enough brought up by both Oil and Maki. So after then having to realize that all of this was a trap and all of this was one massive lie, what better way than to introduce your Doomsday than to introduce the third party, that being the Heaters, as a means of taking advantage of the entire situation by possibly going in there to terminate a weakened Goku, Vegeta, and Granola. But at the same time, what about Frieza? They've of course name dropped Frieza over 10,000 times, and yet even still right now, we haven't seen anything involving Frieza, not even for one single panel. So I don't see Frieza getting involved anytime soon unless something is brought up to where either they find him or he finds them. Either way, this fight on planet Sorrel is going to be bloody, but I don't see Granola besting MUI Goku, and I think that if Vegeta were to be cautious enough and focused enough and prepared enough to do everything and anything he can to get the job done, then I can also see Vegeta erasing Granola if the opportunity were to be presented. But at the same time, I don't want to downplay Granola either, because there is that chance that there is more to Granola than meets the eye, and of course until we see them fight, we're going to have to then reserve our judgment. But I don't think that right off the gate would it be sensical to see Granola just slap Goku and Vegeta, or the opposite, in seeing Goku and Vegeta actually go on ahead to slap Granola, only because I think to establish Granola's wish and to see how even Whis had a very bad feeling that someone just random popped up in Universe 7 and now claiming to be the strongest, while at the same time also preserving Goku and Vegeta's training, I think that right off the gate, this battle involving the two parties should be evenly balanced, even if you want to suggest that Granola goes on to body every incarnation of Goku and Vegeta prior to having Goku use the silver-haired form and using Mastered Ultra Instinct as a means to put Granola down. If you still want to have that be the case, you can, but I think that early on, you don't want to have that be the premise, only because I think that it would be a little too early to set the precedent of Granola bodying the silver-haired Ultra Instinct form that Goku has, because if you want to do that later on with Granola potentially getting stronger and with Goku kind of getting used to who and what Granola is, I guess you could do that, but I still stand against the idea of MUI, Mastered Ultra Instinct Goku, losing to Granola. But the interesting factor here is Vegeta and what they're going to do with Vegeta now knowing and possessing the ability of using destructive energy, which if you guys also pay close enough attention, some of the other gods of destruction don't have the exact earring that Beerus had given Vegeta in bearing that of destructive like energy, which is interesting because if the earring is supposed to be a symbol of a user being able to wield destructive power or destructive-like kind of capabilities, some of the other destroyers don't have earrings, so that's a little interesting here. But needless to say, I definitely think that by the end of this, we're gonna see something come from the heaters to where either Monaito's life is gonna be placed on the line, or the heaters are somehow going to interrupt Goku and Vegeta, which, again, is going to make for a very interesting confrontation, because Toriyama and Toyotaro had introduced a lot of elements in this arc, and one of the many elements introduced are the parties involved. You have Granola, you have Goku and Vegeta, which is a separate party altogether. We have the heaters, which makes now three parties. We have the element of Frieza, which now there are four parties, right? So there are so many characters coming into play here that they're going to have to start cutting the grass a little short here, because you don't want to have too much happening at the same time to where it doesn't make sense or it just feels a little convoluted. I definitely think that the heaters, meaning specifically Gas and Elec, are going to be individuals to keep your eye on, because I think that the way Elec had expressed what he wanted from Gas and kind of using him later on down the road could be something that's plausible in this story. But I think that the way this is being positioned and set up, I strongly believe that this isn't going to go the way we think, or at least be as linear as people predict. But there is without question a lot for us to look forward to, especially in Dragon Ball Super Manga chapter number 72. And until that drops, we can only speculate as to what may or may not happen. But until then, it's going to without question get very bloody as soon as all of these parties end up getting together. But by the end of all of this, I want to get your thoughts in the comment section below involving three specific things. That being number one, what kind of outcome do you think is going to take place following the battle involving Vegeta, Goku, and Granola? Number two, do you guys believe that it's possible for Granola to supersede Ultra Instinct Goku in base but still lose to the silver-haired form? And lastly, is it possible for Granola and the Saiyans to come to somewhat of an agreement in finding out the truth that the Saiyans aren't assassins that work for Frieza, and that the Saiyans aren't really here to destroy Granola, as of course Granola is not meant to be the evil person that Maki and Oil had portrayed to be? So is there going to be somewhat of a resolution between said parties, or is one party simply going to annihilate the other before having to further progress the story? So again, thank you all so much for watching, thank you all so much for your time. If you guys are stoked, ready, and excited to find out what's going to happen next, then I do encourage you guys to go on ahead and smash that subscribe button, click the bell icon to always be notified, give this video a big fat thumbs up by slapping that like button down below if you guys are simply hyped to see this go down, because this so far has the potential in being something good, and I really hope that the writers behind this, Toriyama and Toyotaro, don't end up dropping the ball when it comes down to said circumstances and said battles that are going to occur on Planet Sorrel, or Planet Cereal in this case, because if they were to do that, and if they were to kind of portray one party to be weaker than the other, which is kind of expected by now, then how are they gonna make it up moving forward if said opposition ends up defeating their opponent, when all the while that was exactly why Goku and Vegeta had gone to Planet Sorrel and why Granola is waiting for them? So, and a quick little reminder before you exit the video, if you guys are unaware, follow me on my secondary channels, which are also used to discuss and talk about all kinds of different subjects and topics, including gaming and live streams, beginning with Unreal Network, which is a channel dedicated in discussing all kinds of movies, breakdowns, current events, scary stories, theories, and more. So if you are someone who is into the entertainment world, then that's the channel for you. So head on over and subscribe over on Unreal Network, which up next is Unreal Vlogs, where I bring you guys a little closer into my life and taking you behind the scenes with vlogging content, parody videos, reactions, motivational videos, uplifting videos, and more. So if you want to get to know me on more of a personal level, then that's the channel for you. Hit that subscribe button to always be in the loop with Unreal Vlogs. And lastly, my gaming channel, Unreal Royale, where on that channel we dive more into the world of gaming, ranging from all different kinds of video games, from Dragon Ball to Resident Evil to Grand Theft Auto, Halo, Gears of War, Minecraft, all kinds of horror games, shooters, RPGs, and more, including live streams. So if you're a gamer and are into the gaming world, then smash that subscribe button over at Unreal Royale and experience the ride with me. I want to thank you all so much for your time, thank you all so very much for your support, and I'll be seeing each and every single one of you in the next video.
This is the Galactic Emperor of the Universe, and of course I'm here to tell you to subscribe to Unrelent Gaming.
Also follow Unrelent Gaming on these social media platforms to stay connected at all times. And if you don't, then very soon you will all be dead! Oh, did someone say Unrelent Gaming? Oh my god!
The fuck's up, Bon? Put on some clothes!
Well, why don't you put on any clothes?
What? I don't need clothes, but Jesus Christ, that's huge! What, Broly?
Frieza.
Uh-oh.
Prepare to die! That I'm the biggest Unreal Ant Gaming fan. This is my moment. I'm a part of his notification squad. Universe 7 can have all the fun. I just want the food.
And don't forget to leave a comment on this video. Show some love for the best community on YouTube.
Kakarot!